Hyderabad.
Game nights. It just so happened that she said, we want to play, and we just stopped playing. I don't know how that happened.
But why was it? Well, I'm thinking, why was that?
Because she's a big fat cheetah cock.
I agree.
She's
and a sore loser.
I'm a sore loser and so competitive, and she cannot play one game without cheating.
And really, and no, without, she's like, really bad also.
And she's really bad, so nobody wants her on the team really. But so we just decided to just, you know, we started another group, and she doesn't know about it until now that we actually continue playing on Wednesday nights.
I'm heartbroken.
We can see. So wait, so you have a new game night that she doesn't know about, and she just learnt about it right now.
Yeah, now we're going to have to change it from Wednesdays to Thursdays.
To another day and form another group.
And then I'm just going to arrive there as well.
Yeah.
Basically, they can't handle the fact that I'm so good and I win.
No, they can't handle the fact that she has fear of missing out. Actually, she can't handle
it. Oh, Neha? FOMO is an issue?
No, I don't. But I definitely, like, when I get invited somewhere, and if I don't reach at a certain place. I mean, I always go there, but I go late. And then Anga's like, you want to just not go for this party? And I'm like, no, I don't want to go. And then 10 minutes later, I'm like, yeah, but what if it's a lot of fun? Let's just go check it out. So yeah, I do have fear of missing out.
Although I do want to tell you, around last February, not this February, Manish happened to throw a birthday party for me.
Yeah.
And Neha was very torn because our birthdays are one day apart, Anga than me. They were supposedly not seeing each other at that time. And Neha was at my party, and every 10 minutes she kept saying, I have to go to Angad's. But Angad, I just want to tell you, at that point in life, she chose me over you.
The party which I wasn't invited to, so it's fine.
At least that was just a party, not a wedding.
Yeah, that was a party, not a wedding. Oh!
But you invited Soha.
Well, I wasn't. We have to take this up.
Angan, Shukar Mana that you were invited to your own wedding. The way things went.
Okay.
I'm glad I made it.
So, Angad, since we're talking about, you know, you and Neha, a person that Neha Dupia could hook up with and you won't get upset.
What is that question? These
are the kind of questions you ask your guests on No Filter Neha, which means that, you know, but it's your turn now.
But Neha is very sanskari.
Yeah, see, my friends know me.
George Clooney.
No, I think it has to be me.
No, it can't be you. It has to be somebody else.
Some attractive girl.
Put your Punjabi pun to one side for a second and think of somebody else.
I love that Gaurav is discussing it with Anga and helping him out.
She does not have the ability to hook up with people. Trust me. Let me tell you that.
So, you two are brothers, right?
Can I answer that?
Yeah, please. Can you? Because I know that you have a certain pop icon that you would love to hook up with.
Who, me?
Madonna?
No, but you're close.
Who, I?
Yeah.
Jhelo.
Jhelo.
Jhelo. Kaun inko jhelega? Yeah, but I'm going to say categorically, if Jhelo ever like shows any interest in him, he's going to leave me for her.
So he's allowed J-Lo
and who is she allowed?
No, Nehal never do it.
She's also allowed J-Lo.
Oh, what are you saying? The press is here.
That's the one. That's the headline.
That's the headline.
Okay.
A threesome with J-Lo.
Okay, basically.
Or J-Lo.
Okay, so you refuse to answer. Chalo. Gaurav Kapoor, what is the most annoying thing about Neha's timing, and over the years, has it gotten any better?
Chalo, the good thing you said is that what's the most annoying thing about her timing? You put a topic. Because if we had just said what's the most annoying thing, in log ki din ki sari appointment cancel karni padti. Timing pe bhi ek ghanta to cancel karna hi padega. Kyunki for Neha, I call her on the way. She's on the way, Neha. Always on the way. She will, if she reaches a party 2 hours after the stipulated time or when she said, that means she's still 1 hour early according to her clock. That's what I'll say about it. And over the years, it has not, it's not got better. It has gotten much worse. But it keeps getting worse.
Now she has more excuses also.
Yeah, it's a moving goalpost. It just keeps moving further away.
What's amazing is that there was this one time that Gaurav and Kirat had invited us for a movie. They were like, you know, the movie is at, I think they said 3:30. And we got there and it was just like, oh my God, we're so late. It's like 4:20 when we reach for the 3:30 film. And Kirat, Gaurav's very lovely wife, she's like, no, you're fine. You're on time. Because the movie's actually starting at 4:30, but we told you 1 hour in advance.
So hum aise karte hum. We pad the time by an hour, like a movie. Movie, flight, all these things you have to pad. And if you're calling up for dinner, you have to say 5 p.m.
Yeah.
So that she shows up before.
But if you're an hour late for her brunch, she sunaus you.
Yeah. She was like, oh, you're so late. I said, no. On time.
Angad Bedi has now discovered he has one more talent, which is singing.
You can dedicate the song to me later.
Angad wants to dedicate a song for Neha, and it would be really nice agar aap sab log zara taaliyan baja ke unko encourage karenge.
Kya gaana hai? Kya ho raha hai? Kya ho kya raha hai? Sunao gaana.
Ek baar baby selfish hokar.
Ho gaya hai, hokar hai.
Okay, our wonderful audience and press are wondering what's going on, but it's just Angad's way of trying to make a statement clearly
that
about
I'm,
you.
That I'm selfish.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah, well, you didn't? Okay. Well, you are going to answer this, but before
steer
that,
it away, Sophie. Steer
I'm steering it away.
Away
quickly to Soha, who is going to tell us about the call you got telling you that Angad was getting married, and how did you find out who he was getting married to?
So I have to say that they were seeing each other for a while. I don't think many people knew. I don't know when we found out.
I don't know. What do you term a while?
Exactly. I don't know. But it was a little like Chupa Rustam type. And then
like it started about 5 days before the blind item came out on us.
Right. And then I got a call from my mother one day. I think Neha and Angad forgot that Bishan uncle is a very good friend of my parents. And my mother called me and said, are you coming to Delhi tomorrow? And I said, no, I'm not coming to Delhi tomorrow. And she said, well, Angad's getting married. And I thought, oh no, who's going to tell Neha, bichari? Kisi aur se shaadi kar raha hai. So I said, mujhe usko phone karna padega, kisi ko to batana padega. I said, so then I called like, you know, like other close friends and said, ki kaun batayega bichari now? Because it was, I mean, according to me, it was a new relationship. Itni jaldi shaadi kaun karta hai? So, anyway, so then I called Neha and I thought, okay, from the tone of her voice, I'll be able to understand. But she wasn't sounding very heartbroken. I said, where are you? She said, I'm in Delhi. So I said, oh, I see. At the time. And that's when I realized that Angad is actually marrying Neha.
No, none of us found
my
out directly.
My mother told me.
Yeah, by the way, your mother and me were on a flight a few days after that, and she was still very perplexed by the whole matter.
Yes.
And she said, ye kaise? Matlab, itni jaldi shaadi. Then they haven't done a party also. This is not good. They should do a party. I said, auntie, I will tell
just
them.
Just for the record,
tell them.
For the record, they still haven't done the wedding party, but it's okay.
But you're saying you got a call from your mom.
Yes.
I got a call, and this is very interesting, because again, Bishpa told Ajay Jadeja, Ajay called Ashish Nehra, and anything you tell Ashish Nehra spreads like BBC in 5 minutes, right? Wo aise phail jata hai, theek hai? To Ashu ka phone aaya mere ko. Abe, ye kya kar rahe Angad Bedi? Maine kaha kya ho gaya? Kehta abe kurta press karwa le, kal shaadi hai subah. Maine to karwa liya press. Maine kaha acha, theek hai. And luckily that time I had a missed call from
Neha. But then also then on the phone only said, if you can come tomorrow, then please come.
Yeah, it was a very half-hearted invitation, but I'm Besharam, I went.
You still
reached. I reached.
We'll discuss my invitation later.
Why are we so quiet, Angad?
Aap dono to kuch nahi bole to acha hai.
Chalo, Angad, aap se poochte hain one thing you'd like to change about Neha. Tread carefully.
Dekh, bhai. ये ना गुगली बॉल है ठीक है संभाल के खेलियो इसको
तो भी आउट
होगे
अच्छा है वो दरवाजे के पास वहीं से निकाल देना करो उसे
her sense of timing for sure
that can change
yeah she can be on time for once
पर comedic timing कितनी अच्छी है
was she on time for the wedding पहुंच गई
no
oh
that was my mother-in-law is here wherever she is where
Babs Dupia
yeah we were all there and we were waiting for about an hour and a half it's normal it's pretty normal
It's not bade experience se bol rahe ho Angad Bedi.
I'll tell you what happened the morning of the wedding is that I was supposed to get up at 6 and we have another ceremony where we have to put the chura and stuff. So that what happened was I just pressed snooze a few times and I instead of waking up at 6
aadat nahi hai inko pata nahi tha na inki shaadi hai.
So I woke up 2.5 hours late. So that started late and then when I started getting ready to get to the Gurdwara, Angad called me and I thought he's probably going to be an hour or so. He's like, where are you? I'm here. And I said, on the way. And then later on again, he was just like, where are you? I'm here. I'm like, on the way. And then he was like, just tell me right now, are you going to make it? Oh, you're not coming. I can't wait longer. I've waited for an hour and a half. And I was like, yeah, I'm just getting there. But I mean, to wake up 2 hours late and then finally making it about an hour late for your wedding is not so bad.
Wow, you made up time.
Well, I just want to tell you all, if you want to know any more snippets or stories about how they got married, how they started dating, and all kinds of other gory details, uske liye aapko No Filter Season 3 mein Angad aur Neha ka episode sunna padega, which I'm sure is full of all kinds of No Filter things.
Actually, it's not that much about the wedding because I'm not asking him too many questions about the wedding.
Oh, then we'll just carry on.
But yeah, we've spoken a lot about his past life. His past life
and Bandra, basically.
Very colorful life.
Enna Biba Munda aega sada.
Hi, Biba Munda. To hear more about this Biba body Munda, you must tune into No Filter. But one last question, since we're on weddings, Gaurav Kapoor, aapki shaadi pe Neha committed some sort of blunder or was about to. What was that? क्या नहीं था कुछ
हाँ हाँ वो तो but that's fully expected.
What?
She called me once and she said, you know, I have to go to कहाँ जाना था तूने? South Africa. So I have to go to South Africa for a show. मैंने कहा तो जा. मतलब मैं कोई visa authority तो हूँ नहीं ना. मैं कहती it's coinciding with your wedding dates. मैंने कहा ठीक है. So she, the thing is...
Call drop that time.
No, so what happened is that as anybody who's been married, and especially if you're a Punjabi, you know, a Punjabi wedding is tougher than organizing the Olympics. Ke Olympics are easy to organize, but Punjabi weddings mein jyada events hote hain. So it was a very stressful time for me planning it.
Isliye humne...
इसलिए इन्होंने
हमने किसी को नहीं बुलाया
चुपचाप एक चुपचाप विलेज विलेज कबड्डी मैच की तरह कर लिया इन्होंने 10 लोग बुला के. So it was very stressful for me and she called and she said, I can't. I was like, that's okay. It's your life. It's your choice. You make it. So she got really stressed because I didn't give a reaction. So uske baad mere sare ghar walon ko phone kiya ki ye mujhse naraaz hai, mujhse kabhi baat nahi karega, mujhse kuch nahi karega aur phir ye aa gayi. So I honestly did nothing except say okay because I had 20 things on my head. But she thought I was giving her guilt.
But she showed up.
But it worked.
She showed up and she danced as well and she made a lot of noise as she always does and actually showed up before the wedding was over. She showed up before
the wedding. I organized the entire Sangeet. I got like 9 boys to dance.
And
we beat the girls' side. It was a big deal.
And you were the one who was messing up on the steps the most.
It's fine.
That's because I was dancing with 2 boys who worked.
But yeah, she organized. I have to say, she organized the dance performance. She did very well.